Hi, and welcome to our 8th session about our DevSecOps pipeline with GitLab. In this session, we will have a look at DAST, Dynamic Application Security Testing. As we explained in our last videos, this is our DevSecOps pipeline which we are implementing with GitLab. In our last videos, which you can see all up there, we had a look at software composition analysis, license compliance testing, static application security testing, container scanning, secret detection, and in this session we will now have a look at dynamic application security testing. As you can see in this picture, all of the tests and all of the videos which we have done have been done in the continuous integration. Now, when we are going into continuous delivery, we of course need a running system. Before, all of the tests in the continuous integration have been done statically with code analysis. Now, for the dynamic application security testing, we need to deploy our Docker container and run the Docker container. Paddy, what exactly is dynamic application security testing?
DAST is all about finding vulnerabilities in your running application. So you can think like automated penetration testing. The GitLab default tool to implement this is the OWASP SAP attack proxy. OWASP SAP attacks the running application and tries to find vulnerabilities. Please be aware that without explicit manual configuration, this DAST testing is very, very basic. If you want real testing, you need to invest quite a lot of time to configure OWASP SAP correctly. We won't do that. There is a dedicated session to this topic held by the OWASP SAP project.
So let me guess, it's just adding one line of code and DAST is enabled.
Not quite this time. First of all, we need to define the stage that the DAST job that's configured by default requires. The stage for this is called DAST. But we need to define all the stages, not just the additional DAST stage. This means our GitLab CI.yaml will be extended with the line stages, build, test, deploy, and test.
Okay, but why do we need to define build, test, and deploy?
Well, build, test, and deploy are there by default. But as soon as we start and define stages explicitly, we need to mention all that we want to have. And because our existing jobs require and depend on these steps, we need to define them here too.
You mentioned before that the penetration tests are done with a running system. So how do we do that in GitLab?
Exactly. We need a running system for this. And to get a running system, we first define the variable container underscore test underscore image. It points to the container image we built for container scanning before. Then in the DAST section, that's the job in the GitLab defined file we will include afterwards, we extend services. Services means that for this job, it's possible to access the running container test image by the alias of demo app. Let's see where we need that. The DAST job of GitLab expects a variable Docker image that contains the actual image it should test and run. In addition, we define the dest underscore website variable and let it point to the demo app that we defined as a service before. And just to slightly improve the results, we set also the dest underscore full scan enabled variable to true. The impact of this variable is that OWASP not only performs passive tests, but also active tests, which means it tries to attack actually. And finally, we import and include the GitLab defined template for dest. Let's open our pipeline file and extend it with the changes we mentioned. And we open it in the web editor. Here I add the extension of the stages. Most notably, the dest stage. Next, I add the import statement to make the dest job available to us. Then I add the additional variables we need. And finally, I add the extension of the dest job with the service that we require. And we commit everything.
Did I get that correctly? We now added the stages because we have defined another stage, which is dust, and therefore we needed to add all of the other stages.
Yes.
Then we added the new template for dust, and after that we went and configured the endpoint where dust will test our application and that dust will use a full scan. And as a last step, we extended the dust job so that dust can find the service and can execute the application.
Correct. In the meantime, our pipeline has finished. So let's look what it tells us. Sure enough, we have an additional stage. Let's see what it did for us. If I go to the top here, we see that first of all, the service is started. So our application that's penetration tested is started here. Next, further below, we see that our SAP server is starting. And once started, it begins executing the scan and executes all its tests, which in the end shows us that he found two warnings.
Oh, that's interesting. Two warnings. In our small Java application, can we see the result?
Sure. Again, there's multiple ways to do that. First of all, directly in the pipeline. And here in the security tab. Scrolling down, we see that we have, first of all, in the summary, two new vulnerabilities. And second, we can also filter by Dust. The two findings we have here are very basic. First of all, that we didn't enable HTTPS, for example. As mentioned, if you want real interesting findings, you need to configure SAP in much more detail and also tweak the GitLab flags accordingly. The second place where we see the findings is again in the security and compliance vulnerability report area. Also here, we can filter by tool, in this case, Dust. And we'll see the same two findings again.
So let me quickly recap. We have introduced Dust by adding a new line with the Dust configuration. Then we needed to define the default stages, including the new stage, which is Dust. And afterwards, we configured the endpoint where Dust can find our application. And after that, we defined that Dust uses the full scan so that it also attacks our application. And finally, we extended the Dust job so that the SAP server can find our application and can attack our application.
And now that we have all the security tools in place that we wanted to show you, we'll go to the next stage. In our next video, we will introduce you to the capabilities of the integrated vulnerability management tool of GitLab.